Now let's touch on precision movement using CAD transforms. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about bringing together everything that we've learned within movement, within mesh, within object mode, and showing you how I go about and bring precision through an add-on called CAD transforms. Now, CAD Transforms uses all the basics of Blender movement, but takes it that one step further. So here we are, one last time for movement anyway, on a nice, fresh, new Blender file. Let's go ahead and do exactly what we've just done on all the rest, which is let's select everything, delete it, create ourselves a new cube. Let's set this cube to exactly 1 millimeter. And then let's go ahead and reset the origin point down on that bottom left-hand vertex. And with that now done, you should be pretty damn fast at this too now. Let's go into some quite more advanced movement. Now, I'm saying this, but I don't want it to scare you. I have given you all the knowledge you need to understand exactly what is going on here. So first of all, if this is the first time with Blender, you've got to understand that what we're using here is an add-on that works a little bit differently to what is normal of Blender. So normally an add-on just sort of sticks around here on the side and that's how it lives its life. Well, CAD Transforms, which is the add-on we're going to be using, lives here. And the way that you use it is by activating it. You click it and that's it now on. You click out of it and that's it now off. Now what I do is I set a shortcut for this. So go over to it, I'm going to go right click, I'm going to assign a shortcut. And for me, I like to use Alt-C. And that is how I go in and then I go W to go back up here and then I use Alt-C to go in there. Now, just before we move on, let's go into edit mode, and you'll see if I type in Alt-C, nothing's gonna happen. We have to assign it in edit mode as well, because it is its own environment. So now if I go Alt-C, it works, and that's that. Okay, lastly, before we start playing with CAD transforms, we need to change some preferences, because if not, you're not gonna see this. So make sure you go here, type in CAD, you'll get this CAD transforms and toggle down this drop down menu and you'll see that there's a whole bunch more information here. I'm going to set my font size to something really big like 70. This circle size, I'm going to set it to 25. And then I want to set all of these here to 5. This is the settings that I personally like to use and that's it. If you're wanting to change the mountain of shortcuts that come with CAD transforms, they're right here, but personally, I really think that the shortcuts are perfect. Now I'm going to just save my preferences, brilliant, and now let's get to it. So, CAD transforms, let's turn it on, and I want you to look up on the top left-hand side. What is here? This is very similar to something we've been playing about with for the last few episodes. It's our snapping menu. So these are obviously snapping controls. Oh look, and the tools. It tells you what they are right here. So we've got G for movement, R for rotation, S for scale. Great. And what's this here? This is X-ray. Oh, so it's got its own way of selecting through geometry. Okay. Now, the reason why I'm saying is it's a lot nicer to see this there than going over to tools and then seeing there's a mountain of shortcuts. Trust me, this is so easy, it's unreal what we have at our disposal here. It's incredible what has been created and completely for free. But anyway, first of all, let's go ahead and just do some normal moving. So let's go ahead, we select our object, hit G, nothing's moving. What on earth is going on? Take note, this is a from and to movement style. We're moving from here to there. Now, that sounds something very similar to what we've been doing so far. We've been moving from the origin point to where that origin point is going to end up. The only thing that's different here is we are setting the origin point at the beginning of the movement. So right this minute, we have vertex snapping, And you'll see now that when I get close to a vertex, this round circle appears. I click. This now has set the from point. From here, I can constrain just like normally. Let's go on the x-axis and let's put in a nice simple 1. So that's 1 millimeter. And then let's hit enter. And that's a precision movement done. That fundamentally is CAD transforms. Yes, it might not look like much, but let's go ahead and really explore this. So first of all, I want you to take note that I have an entire video where I've gone really in depth of this, and that there is in the card or linked down below where I show you everything there is to do with this. So with that said, let's go ahead and explore. So we got our movement, G, click. Now here's something interesting. A thing that I absolutely love of CAD transforms is you can now move around while you're doing a movement. Zoom in, zoom out. Just use your middle mouse to move around and pan. Okay, something else that I like about CAD transforms. We can do something called stacked transforms. So we can go on the X direction, move 1 millimeter, and on the Y direction, move 1 millimeter. Brilliant. Well, move 1 millimeter in the other direction. There we go. And then we hit enter, and that's it done. That is stacked transforms. So it's moved 1 millimeter and 1 millimeter from the origin point that I set. However, the origin point is no longer needed. Isn't that just amazing? Okay, now I'm not really going to go into super in-depth of all of this here, but I am going to go ahead and show you some things. So if we go ahead and create a couple of duplications of our cube here, I just want you to see some amazing things that are possible now. So let's go ahead and do some snapping. So let's go ahead and go G. From this vertex, we can snap to that vertex. Great. Well, we know here that is edges. So how do I do that? Well, first, we're going G once again. I'm going to hit spacebar, and that clears all snappings. So nothing's going to snap here. And then I'm going to hit E, and this will snap to any edge. Okay, clear that. I'm going to go Shift E. That gives me edge centers. Brilliant. Well, from this edge center, I want to snap to that edge center. That's great. In fact, I want to snap to this bottom edge center, from this edge center. All of a sudden, movement has just become so intuitive. In fact, what we can do is do things like this. We can go ahead, we can go ahead and hit G, go from this vertex here, then we can go space, Shift F for face centers, and we've just moved our vertex to that face center. Now, if you want to get really crazy, we can go ahead and go G, select our vertex that we're wanting to work with here. Let's move over to this cube here, because we can move now. Let's go ahead and turn on face centers and N for normals. Hold it right there. This is editing Jonathan here, and I haven't explained what a normal is. Now, don't worry about it too much, but in a nutshell, just think of it as the facing direction of a face. So if a face is at a 45 degree angle, the normal is a 45 degree line off that face. And don't worry, we're going to go a lot more into normals, but that's in a few episodes time. And let's go to this face center and go 0.1 millimeters up on the normal. Isn't that just crazy, the precision we can have now? And all of this is also possible within our edit mode. So let's go ahead, let's select all of these cubes, let's go into edit mode, let's select this, let's go Control L, and now with CAD transforms active, let's go G. So we're snapping now. We can remember we can always clear this with space and then set a new snapping. Let's go V for vertex. Let's go from this vertex. Let's go to this edge center over here. So let's go space, Shift E, and there we go. Edge center. Now, what on earth, why is this so cool? Well, the real reason why is because we can do all types of snapping here. You can see in this shortcut that we have snapping to vertices, edges, edge centers, faces, face centers, our grid, perpendicular, all the rest. It's all here, and it's incredible how amazing this is. On top of that, there's things such as averages. So let's go ahead, let's select this once again. Let's go G for movement. Let's select this vertex here. I'm wanting to move between these two points exactly in the middle from where this vertex. Well, I go to this one, I hit A, and then I go to this one over here, and that's now the center. In fact, what you can do is hit A once again, and that's now one third. So that easily, you can go ahead and do some incredible snapping. Now, that's movement. Let's go ahead and take a look at the rest, because there's a lot more to movement than just moving. There's also rotation and scale. Now, that's going to be a little bit trickier, isn't it? Because we know that rotation and scale work a little bit differently when it comes to origin points. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at what's going to happen. So turning on CAD transforms, selecting our object, let's go R for rotation. Brilliant. Now what's going to happen? Let's click. Oh, this strange thing has popped up. I am currently setting our own axis of rotation. So let's say this axis right here, or using the same point here, I go Shift Z. So now I'm just moving our one axis down here. So let's say I'm wanting to go in this general direction. So now we've got this axis set up. Or we can go R, and let's say I wanted to go from here to there. And now I'm rotating on this axis, and of course, I've set up our own plane here, our own custom plane. So we can go on the X, we can go also on the Y of this plane that is being set up. Okay, so how does that work with scaling then? Well, scale is the same. You have to set up your from and to, and now you're scaling. Now, here's something really interesting. We know that if we do scale, we're going to be breaking our cube, right? So if we go here, select our cube, go scale from here to there, let's set this to 3.2 millimeters. Let's hit enter. Our scale is automatically applied. Do keep in mind that this teeny tiny bit of rotation does come every now and then when you do scaling. So just be aware to go here and just set these to zero, and that's going to sort you out. That is the teeny tiny bit of miss precision that you can get. But when I say miss precision, we are working for objects of 10 millimeters, which is 0.00001 millimeters of precision. And for things that are about 1 meter in size, this is going to be about 0.00006 millimeters. This is exactly the same for most 3D mesh programs from things like 3ds Max and Maya. Of course, it's not absolute precision, but in my eyes, I've never needed 6 decimal places of precision. And I know that I've had all the precision that I need from this. But it's just something to be aware of. And I do know that things are being worked on to try and fix this, but just be aware of it, and it does not break precision modeling at all within Blender for this. Okay, now let's go into scaling, and let's take a look at one other thing. So we scale this here. What happens if I wanted to do two-dimensional scaling? Well, for that, I'm going to hit Tab. That gives me two-dimensional scaling. What if I wanted three-dimensional scaling? Well, three-dimensional scaling is just with Tab once again. And like all of these, if we were to go ahead and click one of these, and we go ahead and add a rotation, so let's set this rotation there, and let's hit G. Now we're moving, Well, we can go ahead and constrain it on the Y, and it has its local axis first. And then if we go Y once again, it's going to go to its global axis from there. Now, if you wanted to create your own axis, you can go ahead and hit C. And now it's asking you, okay, well, where do you want to go? Well, we really shouldn't have set a point first. We should really set our own axis first. And then it's going to say, okay, well, from there, you've now set, that's going to be your X from this point there. So there is a very powerful way of doing your own movement. Now, if you want to learn a lot more about CAD transforms, I advise you to go and check my video that I did going through absolutely every single one, but you don't have to for this series. I will be showing you every single control that I do of CAD transforms within our precision series. Well done for getting through that video. Yes, it's probably way too much information, but that's totally fine. Don't worry about it. CAD transforms is something that you're going to be learning through the entirety of this series, because it fundamentally is the way that I do precision movement within Blender. Yes, Blender movement can do all of this, but CAD transforms just makes it so much easier. Now remember, I've mentioned it once in this video, actually a few times, but there is a link down in the description to see a very long version of the CAD transforms sort of breakdown of everything you can do with it. If you want to learn more about CAD transforms, go down there. But you don't have to, because the rest of the series will be learning it anyway. Stick to the end for a little something extra. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it is the real reason I can do things like this. And if you think I'm worthy of your support and enjoying what I'm making here, I would love to see you there too. Thank you for watching. Keep making, and let the quest continue. Down in the description is this small obstacle course to make sure you've understood all the fundamentals of CAD transforms. And along with that is also a solution video down there in case you get stuck.